Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Australian Under 20 Junior Championships. I'm joined by one of the all-time greatest players this country has ever seen. A man I've been fortunate enough to know my whole life. Someone I've looked up to idolise the entirety of my life. Mr. Cal, the Black Pearl, Bruton. How you doing, Cal?
I'm very well, Jordan, and thank you for that introduction. I have to pay you a little bit later, man, but it's great to be here to see these young athletes, boys and girls, put it on the line in such a prestigious event as the Under 20 Championships.
Absolutely. And obviously, for those of you who don't know, Cal is always giving back to the game, and this year we're very fortunate enough, or Basketball ACT is very fortunate enough, to have him as part of their coaching ranks, and this year he helped lead the ACT boys. How was the week, Cal?
Yeah, it was a bit of a tough week for us. But at the same time, it was very, very well taken by the players in terms of the challenges that it presented. I think that the teams that we played, such as the Queensland team, the Tasmanian team, who are now in the finals, the Victorian team, who are reigning champs and going forward again, are very, very talented from 1 through 10. Whereby in ACT, we're a little bit unfortunate that we have players that basically get recruited to other codes, and as a result, we miss out on them. And of course, we had a couple of players that played last year, bottom age, that went on to the States to accept scholarships, such as Tad Dufamayo Jr., and a gentleman by the name of Ian Morrison, who's a very, very talented player. So I think next year we had 6 guys that were bottom age this year. So next year, that experience should hold them in good stead.
One of the biggest things, obviously, the talent pool in Australia seems to be growing and growing. What were your thoughts on the talent that was here this week overall?
I think it was great watching the different styles of play and also the competitiveness. I thought that most teams really left it on the floor after every game. I was impressed with this Tasmanian team. I don't know how long they've been playing together, but it looked like they've been together since they were 5 years old, the way they play off each other. I thought also the Vicks are just a standout team from top to bottom. You know, they got a 6'10" monster sitting in the middle, and it makes it difficult for everybody that's trying to match up with them from that point of view. But all the teams, New South Wales, they handed it to us by 40. I thought that was the best team I saw until all of a sudden Tasmania come out and smacked them by 20. I thought, geez. So, yeah, all the teams played well. Queensland, who I thought was very talented, obviously didn't have the chemistry the way probably the other clubs did that finished in the top four. But yet still, when it came to having to win a game and put it on the line, you know, they came up and answered the bell as well. So I think it's a great future for Australian basketball when you can see these sort of guys looking forward to, and girls looking forward to, stepping into their next career, their next stage of their careers.
So we've seen the team introductions here, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see from your TV screens, we have got Tasmania playing Victoria, and this is to fill you in, Cal. This is a bit of a rivalry match. These two teams have been going at it for the last couple of years. You know, as you identified, you know, Tasmania with a very much a penetrate, kick, and shoot the open three style of play, whereas Victorians are talented across the floor through 1 through 10. I mean, I think their physio can play, for goodness sake. there's definitely going to be some matchups here to watch. Who for you has been the biggest or the most talented kid here? I mean, I know it's a team sport, but you know, you're one for identifying talent. Obviously, the Bruton name carries a strong history in Basketball Australia folklore, but who for you is the kid to watch in today's game?
Well, I think it's DJ, this kid everybody's talking about for Victoria.
Vasiljevic?
Yes. He's just athletic.
Yep.
He's poised. He's got the tenacity. You know, he's got that little nastiness about him when it comes down to competing. And to me, he's a sleeper, you know, a guy that probably could hold his own in NBL right now.
Absolutely.
You know, so he was impressive. I also like, I don't know his name, but 20, what is it? Number
35.
Yeah, that's Danny Krebs' son, I believe. Is it?
I believe so, too.
Yeah.
I think you're
I like him. He shows that he's not afraid, you know, and he backs himself. He's coming in with the handles, and he's about 6'6 or so, and he's coming off the dribble. He pull up, wet jumper. That's my little terminology when it hits about. He's got a, and he doesn't mind mixing it up with the best of them. So I think when you got those kind of players that are going now clash for the big prize, you're going to see some exciting basketball here this afternoon.
Absolutely. We've got 3 minutes to play, ladies and gentlemen, before Victoria will defend their national championship. Obviously, as you saw or heard from the great Hall of Fame, Cal Bruton, there are some players to watch in this tournament. They have been putting on a show. We're very fortunate enough today, this afternoon, to have some great names coming through the ranks as Cal waves to someone who's produced some players.
She's producer. She's a producer.
Quite well. Penny Bairstow is here, and obviously her daughter Steph is here. Cam's obviously doing extremely well with the Chicago Bulls at the moment. You know, the Smith family name is obviously, you know, here with Alana, obviously, you know, daughter of Darren and niece of Jason. You know, it's good to see, you know, yourself and a number of families that have been folklore in Basketball Australia now at that next level, and that name continuing on.
Yeah, I think that's so important, and the country is so blessed in that way that even from an American point of view, a lot of the players that came out in the early years are naturalized and decided that they would call Australia home. And then you got players such as Dante Exum, who's now in the States. You also have the Ben Simmons, Jonah Bolden. You know, you got these caliber players that are now almost prime time to come back and play for Australia in the next Olympics. And all of a sudden, the Olympic team is looking like a tough pick, you know. But in saying that, if we can get the bogus and the established players like the Patty Mills and Aaron Baines, and get them to sort of maintain, there's a definite medal chance right there, you know, which augurs well for the future of the game.
This is part of the pathway, you know. This is something that Basketball Australia, you know, all those coaches, yourself included, have done a tremendous job in continuing to push those developing players to that next level. Obviously, you know, the big question mark is what do the kids do from here? But by all means, as you said, it looks like the Boomers of the future and the Opals of the future are not going to be one to mess with.
No, I believe they're going to be totally reputable over the next 10 years, you know. Because of that pathway coming through the 20s, and I had a bit of a laugh when we had our little introduction where they were laying down the law of the rules and all that, and talking about all the American scouts that are here looking to recruit, and they're not allowed to talk to any of the players or the coach. That lasted all of 5 minutes here before you see all of them up there trying to get their little 2 cents in and offer these kids an opportunity. I believe at this point in time, there's over 400 kids playing in U.S. colleges. And when they come back, we got to provide them with opportunity to play. But you know, I'll still stick to the old adage that they're going over there to get education first and foremost. Yes, there will be a few that's going to trickle through and maybe make it to that WNBA and NBA status. But for the most part, they come back and they might have a chance to represent their country and bring all that good news back here, as well as that the coaching techniques that they have, and dump them back into the next group coming through, you know?
Definitely. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. As I said, I'm joined by the great man, the Black Pearl, Cal Bruton. We're just about ready for tip-off here as Victoria, the home side, will take on Tasmania, led by Tanner Krebs and Kyle Clark. We've got some very big boys on the floor, and I hope that we can put on a show for you tonight, as we see the Victorians win the jump, and the ball goes to Tom Wilson. DJ Veseljevic looking inside early to Jock Perry, the big fella.
He started out the game just like that in the last five games. They know where their bread is buttered. So they go right downstairs to the big fella, and they get an answer straight away. But if you watch the Tasmanian team, they'll move them around, run them off the picks. Here's the guy I like. And he knows how to hit the open man. Drive and dish. And they're going to have trouble handling that, the Vicks. because they don't mind Tasmania. They're hustling it up. But there you go. You can't. The big fella. When you're 6'11" and weighing in about 120 kg, I don't know, he's not that big, but you know what? He's tough to handle down there.
And you know, there's something that I don't, you know, this kid had some, you know, had some personal health issues a couple of years ago, and he, you know, it's good to see a kid like that, you know, survive, show some resilience and handle it obviously extremely well, and now get back on the floor and play at the top level again. You know?
I did hear that, and he was really, the tumor and all that, that sounded very dangerous, but to see him, I see him occasionally around the AIS. Yeah, he's really quite comfortable with himself now, and I believe his future is very bright. He better start wearing sunglasses.
See Clark with a handoff. Jack Flight White, as they call him in basketball Victoria, Jack Flight White. Obviously one of the Centre of Excellence kids. As you said before, the Victorians are very gifted in that they have several Centre of Excellence kids. It makes it tough.
Yes, they get that expert training from all the top coaches, and they do it six days a week, full-time ballers, you know? So it's hard to discount them. And when you look at Jack White's body for a young kid, you know, he is just built like there's no tomorrow. And I'm sure the scouts are here raving and waiting to get his attention so he can come play at this university.
As we see Chilcott get the turnout and then get the layup again. The Victorians lead 6-4, 2 minutes in. Here's the boy you mentioned. Wow. TJ Veseljevic.
You know, he is so poised with his jumper and is so pure. But at the same time, I saw him back big fellas down the lane and just box them in. But you better watch out. Tazzy's free. They play loose. You know, when you got players that basically don't care in terms of a hit or miss, they just going to let it fly because they done put in enough shots to know that the next one's going to go down. If I miss it, they're tough to deal with.
Absolutely. And that's exactly right, Carl. We saw Kyle Clark nail a big three and Jack White working the offensive part. Just like you said, you know, that body, you know, he finds himself in the right position and he's just a man playing against some boys.
Yeah, his arms are so long he can stand up and tie his shoes.
Clark.
He's 3-for-3. He's saying, I want to be recognized today. Who's going to guard me? There he is, wet.
Krebs, as Cal identified, one of the kids to watch, number 35, and obviously Kyle Clark, number 11 for Tassie. And they are stacked with shooters. We see him put up another three and run down the offensive rebound. It'll be Victoria ball.
All out play with Victoria. Substitutions, the way of the Tasmanian side. Number 12, Tamita Finnow, is on the floor, along with number 30, Samuel Yule.
As you said, Cal, obviously it's going to be a different style of play that we're going to see here. You know, Victorians obviously are known as going inside early to jock, and they've got some men playing against boys. But Tassie have seemed to fill their roster with, you know, smaller, quicker, strong guards that can all handle the ball, can all shoot it. You know.
And they have a defensive mentality too. You know, you got to earn shots. You know, they're not giving up anything free. I like him too.
Tom Wilson, obviously Tom, another one of those Centre Excellence kids. You know, is. As Andre has identified, you know, they've moved him to the point now, so you'll see him handling the ball a lot. And they've moved DJ to the two, and it seemed to pay off dividends. You know, in the recent FIBA Oceania, you know, DJ hit a massive shot to win them the game in the final, and Tom Wilson, obviously, at that point, you know, makes him a tough matchup.
And they hustle. Ooh! they hustle really well. And you know, Tom Wilson is just long and athletic as well. And when he can handle the ball, he'll be a very sought after guard because he's so tall. But oh, he made an error there. Threw a soft pass, but you don't see that too often. Oh.
We get another one. Tom Wilson going out of bounds, trying to get the contact. And the coach, Trevor Lee, is not happy about Victoria whilst they lead 14-12. Timeout, Victoria. 5 minutes 21 to go. 14-12 to the Victorians. Obviously, we're at the one of the biggest basketball stadiums in the country, Cal. You know,
in the world.
In the world, absolutely. You know, and for a lot of kids coming into this atmosphere, you know, it's a new experience. It's a challenging one. You know, what did you find was the best kind of, I suppose, advice you could give to kids preparing to get to this stage? You know, to come and play at the national level.
Well, you obviously need to pay attention to your coaches. You know, if you're a young player and you can work your way through your initial club coach to try to get the best out of that situation, to be rewarded with an opportunity to get into representative size where you can get the coaching at another level. If you get a chance to then represent your state and going away to different competitions from under 14s right through, then you got a chance to be seen by the Center of Excellence coaches and also National Basketball League or WNBL coaches. And before you know it, you're getting a chance to compete against older people. And I think the experience that you gain from that, the toughness that you gain from that, will always help you in good stead. But nothing happens without the effort. You have to put it in early in terms of your practicing your fundamentals and working really hard to develop your game to a level where you can continue on very easy once you master the fundamentals. Look like Tasmania fought their way right back into this, and they scrapping. They trying to make everything difficult and use up clock by putting on their little press and making making Victoria kind of earn that.
As we see DJ put up another three. That seems to be his spot.
He's wet.
He's wet. You heard it here first. The Black Pearl has probably given the kid a new nickname. Wet.
Yeah, it's like when that jumper just hit the cores and, you know, all you see is the sweat dripping up. Oh.
Tasmanian ball, obviously. Abby Akintola is just committed to Denver University.
So they already signed him already. I think it's two kids from Tassie already going to St. Mary's.
Yes, there is. Obviously, Kyle Clark and Tanner Krebs both committed to St. Mary's. Obviously, they've got a rich history of signing Australians. Recently, they obviously retired one of our greats, the current greats, I suppose, Paddy Mills.
Well, Paddy is, you know, what he's done for Australian basketball in his short career has just been huge. You know, you know, obviously, NBA championship gives you a lot of credibility, and with that comes, you know, the anointment of being the country representative at the highest level. So I got a feeling that still Patty's best is yet to come because he's only a young man. Once he can get over the injury bug and make sure he gets a full opportunity to compete, you know, in all year round, because he's definitely a workaholic on this game, then I believe the next young indigenous kids will probably get a chance to see him play a lot more and then come to the surface, because I think there's a lot of talent out there on that end of the spectrum as well. But we don't get to see it because they don't get those opportunities to play in the association level basketball or get to the representative stage.
And you're exactly right, Cal. And I think, yeah, on from that, obviously, Paddy Mills has gone on to, you know, was key of the basketball ACT program and, you know, obviously a huge success story. Won a championship with San Antonio Spurs, obviously still recovering recovered from the shoulder surgery. But, you know, he's also taken, you know, gone and done similar things to you in terms of giving back to the grassroots. And recently he was appointed as our key ambassador for the Aussie Hoops program, which is all about exactly what you were talking about, identifying those kids early. I think it's a program for primary age school kids. You know, you go go check it out on aussiehoops.com.au. And, you know, Basketball Australia doing a great amount of work, as you have done. And I know that you and your son, CJ Bruton, is someone who's, again, part of the basketball folklore, doing a lot of work at grassroots to promote the game and get it out there to the greater community.
Yeah, we enjoy that. You know, I think, you know, we do it because we love the game, and we feel that the young kid wanted to benefit from it and benefit from us passing that knowledge on. By all means, we're totally open to it, and we travel to do it. We're going to the country areas who we feel somewhat underserviced in a lot of areas. You're getting a lot of parents that want to help out their kids, but they get roped into coaching, and they really haven't done any playing of the game, or they haven't really done any courses. So all of a sudden, they're needing help. And if we can go down and coach the coaches and give them a chance to sort of assist with the developing the players and give them some knowledge, then I think that will augur well, again, for getting more volunteers and into the game. So it's no doubt that the game only grows with the coaching. You know, you got guys in the States, you know, the Hubie Browns, and guys are 80 years old, you know, still considered the top teachers, you know. You get the Mike Kays and the Dean Smith, God bless him, he just passed away. But guys like that are tremendous. Tasmania just tied it on up.
7-all off the back of a Tanner Krebs three. Surprisingly, Chilcott is the leading scorer for Tasmania, although you can expect Krebs and Clark to get hot late. As we see Tasmania up the floor and running, and Victoria have gone a little bit smaller now to try and ease that matchup problem.
Yeah, you can see that, but these guys are used to playing that way. And their offense is such that they're always in attack mode. They'll lull you to sleep a little bit, but they curl into the bucket. And if you don't guard them, it feels good. They're going to let it fly. There you go. Whack.
Did he get it off in time? Yeah. Either way, Victoria will retain it. And again, there'll be another sub. Now, this is an interesting sub. Young kid checking in now, Kai Woodfall. He's originally a Tasmanian, moved over here for basketball opportunities. His family relocated over here, and now he gets a chance to play against probably some of the kids he's grown up with and played with, since, like you said, since he was five.
Well, I believe his mom is a super player, Veal. Yeah, really.
Yes, he was.
And it is nice to see, particularly when he's a midget like myself. You know, you like to see them just earn their way and get into this level. And then when they get their chance, they go, yes, I'm taking it, you know. So that's all good. I think, you know, more credit to him. You know, he had to go in Tassie, or he works his way up to represent the Victorian side and go to school here so he can double up with the education side and get his basketball in and play with the best players that Australia has to offer. Why not?
Two or three times this week, and I don't want to be that helpline defender.
He made a statement there. He made a statement, yeah.
As we said before, ladies and gentlemen, there will be a dunk contest at halftime, and unfortunately Jack White will not be playing in it because obviously he is here as part of the gold medal game.
Nah, he would maybe hands down take it home. So it's probably a good thing he is in the locker room getting this halftime break.
It's only a two-point ball game. 1 minute 44 to play in the first. Victoria lead by two, 19-17.
They're mixing up their defense is nice. The Tasmanians, so they're trying to keep everything out. Nice move.
And I suppose, Cal, that's probably the biggest thing is that, you know, against a Victorian team who are so strong at every position, you know, and are so deep, you know, the other thing going for them is their execution is on point. So if you don't change it up, I'm guessing as a coach, you're going to be in a world of hurt.
I agree. And I think when you look at that opportunity there, that was a lesson for every young player. You shoot, you miss, you know where it's going.
Absolutely.
go right after it, get it, put it in. They're showing them something different all the time, and I like the way they've been coached. I believe this Ben Rush has had these kids for a while.
Ben Rush obviously been in Seabrook for a number of years and obviously a well-credentialed coach, took the reins and has done a tremendous job of preparing his boys to play at the top level all week. They haven't really had an off day as such. And as we see the end of the first quarter, Victoria are only up by two, 21-19. And surprisingly, it's not Clark and Krebs leading the way, it's Chilcott with 7 points.
And that's great, too. You know, they just show they got the overall balance. But more importantly, I feel that Tasmania is not intimidated. And most of these teams come up against Vic. Yeah. You know, they're getting popped in the first quarter, and then it's like downhill from there, you know. Raise our hands, we're one of them, you know. We're down nine, and then they come out in the first few minutes, and they blow you out, and in 2-3 minutes, they're up 20 yards. Because they got that sort of firepower. But Tasmania is controlling the tempo on the game in a lot of ways because they're trying to trap, turn the heat up defensively in the backcourt, let them use up some seconds. And now, as a result of it, Victoria had to go to their bench and start matching up with them. So that's when you know you're doing the job.
And as we saw in the women's final, obviously, you know, if you give the Victorians an early lead, they will jump you, as you said. So the closer you can keep them, the better it's going to be for at the end of the game when all the chips are on the table and everyone's going to take that last shot.
Yeah, now you don't want to be behind the eight ball with them because the catch-up side of it is tough, particularly when they can get the stops, consecutive stops. They have a good defensive philosophy. You know, they try to keep you out of the paint and force you to beat them from the outside, which Tasmania's not afraid to do, you know. Shit, they're going to say, oh, you're going to give me that? Well, I'm going to take it, you know. And if you get a run on, you see it like, And it's a Clay Thompson. Those two were Splash Brothers. Shoot, they'll let it fly. They'll go down swinging from the three. But more times than not, they're going to be wet. and that opens up everything on the inside when they stretch you out like that.
And obviously Andrew Bogut has reaped the rewards, hasn't he? Impressed a lot of people around the world with his play and facilitated a lot of that as well, and getting offensive rebounds and just doing a job and being patient.
Well, he's a big body and he's a good passer. And when you're unselfish, you can always play on anybody's team.
As many of getting that penetration going, extra car.
And the lead. Now you got number 34 out there guarding the point guard. He's not afraid. Good sportsmanship there.
3 seconds left on the shot clock. The Victorians will need to score here to take back the lead.
There's Jake. Jump, step back.
And the Tasmanians continue to look to push the ball off every deep. Of every defensive rebound or every Victorian miss.
Oh.
Brown trying to go to work against White.
I like how they two hands on the ball, all on their two-hand pass.
Krebs to three, can't get it to go. Woodfull will pull it out and look to execute on the offensive end. Another offensive rebound for the Tasmanians. They're getting early shots early in the shot clock, and that seems to expose a little bit of a defensive mishap from the Victorians in their rotations, unfortunately.
He's going to bully him in there. That's what I'm saying. They're not intimidated. They really feel like, okay, we give them to play our game, we'll win. Yeah.
Absolutely. As we see that Matt always with a big look at a three, just can't get it to go. The extra pass out of the corner.
I like them boys.
As we see McCarthy run the floor, and always feeding for the layout. It just seems to be, like you said, Cal, that Tasmania seems to play with a lot more freedom and the flow is more continuous, whereas Victoria a little bit at the moment disjointed and it gets stagnant at times.
Oh, awesome in there. And one.
And it will count.
They support each other really, really well. Like, when a guy goes for a shot, you got two guys going for the glass. So they almost treat it like every shot's a missed shot. And they go anticipate it not going down. But more times than not, they're wet. You know? And they're out there, but they're still in the position. And therefore, they set up their defense because now they're right there in the position underneath the basket to put pressure and let them force Victoria to use up some clock in getting into their offense. Yeah. But now they done changed five. They done brought in the fresh boys. And they're going inside to jock.
Oh, wow. Abby Akintola.
He's tough.
Another candidate product of, obviously, Basketball Australia's Centre of Excellence. Tanner Krebs, yeah. Work on DJ.
That's
a Devic.
Oh.
Puts up Hail Mary.
Here you go, pushing it. Oh, stripped him.
Steal.
What I've noticed is that Victoria doesn't have a lot of transition baskets like off a miss. They got a couple off beating the press. But they're not giving them anything easy, Tasmania. Oh.
Steve Barker with another layup.
Oh. They back each other. He gets beat. Bang. There's number 12 there to fill the spot.
They go inside to Jeff Terry, who makes light work of the post defense. And the Victorians trail by three. Which is not somewhere they've been this week. They have not been down in many games, I think, at all.
They haven't. They haven't, and they feel confident enough in their abilities that they're not going to stop attacking Victoria, you know, and as a result, you can see that Victoria's got two fouls. So, you know, they're working the clock. If they can get to the foul line, they're a very good free throw shooting team. And all of a sudden, the clock is stopped while they're adding up points. So that all augurs well for them to sort of maintain a lead. And basically, if they play the solid defense and limit Victorians to one shot.
And you see Tanner Krebs check out for the first time. He's found his way to the foul line. And he and Kyle Clark, obviously two players that Cal correctly identified, players to watch of the tournament and of the future, ladies and gentlemen. You know, have worked their way onto the scoreboard and find a rhythm, as smart players do, by getting easy buckets at the foul line.
There's a lob going inside. He's going back inside there.
Tasmania switching everything. Oh. Now out in running.
There you go.
Barker draws the foul. Abby Akintola and just can't finish the jam. That would have been something spectacular.
Yeah, he's chasing down. You can see he's going for it. Meet me on the third floor. Everybody up. I like the way Tasmania is playing. It's personal. That little island down at the bottom tip. I'm saying, you know what? This is our year. You know? And the Vic's got a lot to say. We're going to have a big say in this. But I think in the rounds, it helps when you get spanked and what have you. You get a chance to then go have your little scouting report, revise your game, And Victoria's had it pretty easy, as you said, all the way through the tournament. So now the pressure's on. But when you got DJ out there.
He is wet from that
spot.
I think if there was a three-point contest for the men's, I think he'd be taking all shots from right there.
Yeah, that's it. That's it. I like they got Jock outside there, keeping him out of the paint. Oh, they're hustling on that glass. They gang rebounding. Oh, that's where you go to your bench and you say, well, don't make no mistakes for me. Just maintain. Oh.
Yeah.
That's the fourth, 4-0. Now watch what happens when with Tazzy. My man did his job. He got his couple minutes in there. The spell.
As we're stuck, we're about to see Tanner Krebs check back in. Obviously, Ben Rush recognizing, as you said, Cal, that you know, you want your most potent offensive players on the floor when you're about to be in the bonus. And 4:20 in a national championship is a long time to be in a bonus.
Exactly. Now, I think Vic got to go to the zone, so that's where they're trying to mix it up now. Because they got to protect that bonus situation they're in now. And they'll sit jocking there, but that could have been a mistake with the shooters that Tasmania got on the perimeter. So here we go. We'll see. If they stick this first one, then they better get out of it quick. Here you go. There's Krebs.
Uh-oh.
No long. Okay. One stop.
That also, I suppose, takes away the, as you see, Tom Wilson, strong move to the rim. The Tassie boys were beating them on the glass early too, and that's obviously made Trevor Lee aware of making a change.
Krebs is not shy. He's come out too. That's where you got to be patient. Like Tom Wilson, he's casual as. He's got that good look too, so he's gonna be doing the catwalk stuff, you know, in the future, you know.
As we see Ben Rush take a timeout, obviously he wants to change something up as the Victorians go into the zone. We've got some leaders. DJ Veseljevic is obviously on 9 points. He's gone 3 of 3 from behind the arc and leading the Victorian scorers. Whilst everyone else is contributing, but the big surprise for the Tassie boys is obviously that Barker is 12, Clark has worked his way in the game with 10, Chilcott with 7, and Krebs is still only 5. He's had a few shots from outside. I mean, he's a kid to watch, but you don't want to discount him because he will light it up and it will become a shootout.
Well, you know, the shooter's mentality is what it's all about. You know, you can miss 1, 2, 3 in a row, your next one's going down, you know, and he's got to have that sort of belief in his ability, which I'm sure he does. I don't think his dad was too shy either, you know, when he played. But he's also a very good, high-percentage player.
Absolutely.
Like, you know, I believe Ted Krebs came after me, but he's done some really good things down in Tassie. He played for the Devils as well. And you just believe that when kids grow up with that sort of American heritage, they also got that self-belief, you know. And regardless, they watch a lot of basketball, so they become students of the game.
As we see, Victoria stay in the zone, and they get Tassie get a wide-open look from the corner, and it won't go. And the Victorians look to push it down the floor early. White going baseline. There it is.
Yeah, he's twice, he's looking down in the rim. Say, anybody want to come up here with me? Everybody's moving out of his way.
As we see Perry get his hands on a loose ball, and the Vicks looking to run.
Oh, nice move.
Wilson draws the contact, but can't finish. The Tassie boys trying to push the tempo just to get get it away from this zone. But the Vicks managed to slow it down.
Yeah, the zone's working right now very effectively because they've had three outside shots and none of them going down. That's four.
Obviously getting open looks, but as you said, Cal, you know, if you're going to rely on outside shooting and there's going to be no penetration against the zone, you're going to live and die by the three. Vicks breaking it down into an on-ball situation.
Oh, nice, nice. Oh. I like the setup, though. DJ just penetrated nice. Krebs, this is the one. Okay, well, now he's got to look to penetrate. He's got to look to do something else because he's like 0-for-3, 0-for-4, but he needs to try to get to the foul line.
So see the Vicks pounded inside. Perry will go against Krebs and then dish it out. Wilson almost trying to mark it in the air and throw it back down.
Oh, he's going again.
Wow.
I love this game. He's like, yeah, you know what?
I think you've seen that before, Cal, and I think I know someone that may be related to you who has the same sort of mentality. I can understand and appreciate why you love seeing shooters have no conscience.
Yep.
Here he goes again.
There you go again. Bad luck. Oh, I think he blew that call.
The Victorian home crowd taking exception to that call.
He's from Tasmania. Nah.
Krebs is obviously 2 of 7 from the three-point line, but he's hit some big buckets at the right time.
Strong. Yep.
Here he goes again. Oh, making the extra pass. Clark inside. Perry just a little bit too late.
They look for each other really well, you know. It's like their philosophy is one more pass. You know, make that extra pass.
Wilson for three. It is in and out. Perry. You're right. He's 6'11". You got to guard it.
And he's going to be 6'11" at the end of the game, too.
Wow.
On the buzzer. I don't think I've seen Victoria in the deficit any time during this tournament at halftime.
Not at the end of any quarter I've seen, and not at the end of any first half I've seen. This is uncharted territory for them in many ways. Obviously, as you said, the Tassie boys are shooting without a conscience. They're currently sitting at 6 of 22 threes for the half. When you're shooting 66% of your shots from beyond the arc, that's a lot of threes.
That's the way they feel they're going to beat them. You know, they're going to unload out there. They got to come out, and as soon as they start to come out, the Victorians, then they're going to start doing their penetration and dishing and have them chasing. So if they decent from the three-point line, it's got to be respected. You know, you got to get out on them. And that's where I suppose this quickness and speed and the matchups become a little problem for the Victorians.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're at halftime of the men's grand final. Obviously, we're about to have something really new, and Cal's about to leave us because he's about to go be a judge for the boys' dunk contest. So, Cal, I'll let you get down there, obviously, and we'll wait to see some of your scores and obviously some of the hops of the boys.
You know,
he will be joining us for the second half, ladies and gentlemen. The score is 38 Victoria to Tasmania's surprising 42. As I said earlier, we're looking at a Tassie team who have shot, stand corrected, sorry, 7 of 23 three-point lines. 7 of 23 from the three-point line, shooting at 30%, but they've only shot the ball 38 times. So to have an extra 15 shots that are actually coming from inside the three-point line is quite scary, and obviously can lead to, as we are seeing, a Tasmania lead.
I mean, seriously, we have no one from the ACT.
here we go for the dunk contest. Make sure you check us out on all social media. Obviously, Basketball Australia doing a tremendous job of running their pathway programs through the Australian Junior Championships. Check us out. Make sure you use the Facebook or the hashtag on Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook. Hashtag AJC, that is Australian Junior Championships, or AJC for Australian Junior Championships. We're about to see our first off dunk contest at halftime of the under-20s Australian Junior Championships. We've got a kid by the looks of things from WA. We've got a kid from Queensland. We're looking for someone now from ACT, South Australia, and New South Wales. Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to see some serious action. Basketball Australia putting on a tremendous show. Big thank you, obviously, to Dandenong Stadium. This team here, the management team, obviously led by Dave Graham, his wonderful team of staff have done a tremendous job. The volunteers, the management board, the community has really got behind this event. They've hosted a WNBL semi-final last week prior to this tournament, and we're about to see some of Australia's best talent take to the floor. Dave Graham joins us as the CEO of Dandenong Basketball, as one of the scorers, the great man, Cal Bruton. Andrew Gaze, no introduction is needed for these two. Here we go, first dunk from Dylan from Queensland.
This should be good.
360 one-handed jam is off the back of the yard.
That looked good.
Queensland, the scores will be out of five. Here he goes again. Oh, two-handed. 360.
360. He got up. Oh, hey.
Andrew's got eight. Somebody who does math, can you keep a tally, please? Because that will give us actually finish your eight of school. So
25 out of 30 for his first
game. Next up, not a bad dunk. Also from Queensland, Daryl.
Get up, D! Hey, DJ!
Daryl McDowell.
Daryl's just going to try and get it in the hoop. Okay. So that turns out to be a 360.
And he's going to do a cap with a cap. With a cap. Here we go. That was good.
Yeah,
that was good.
And what have we got from the judges? David Graham's got an 8. Cal Brick's got an 8. Andrew Gaines has got a 7.
Score of 8 and 7.
We're almost there.
That was...
David from WA. Now,
well, I know his dad can get up, so...
And apparently, he's got more...
Down.
Daryl McDowell, my senior, obviously played for and his championship, a premiership winning player with the Brisbane Lions 3 times.
I know. I need socks. He's very confident.
Dylan's back up. With an intellectual disability to play the great game of basketball. And Basketball Australia do a great job of moving pathways to athletes with disabilities or other disabilities.
Queensland represent.
See Dylan take off his second dunk. Real legs.
Oh, that's a good. Well, stuck.
Concept is very sound.
I don't know if that's minus points or if that's actually bonus points. He's going to go out again.
Oh!
One attempt left. You either stick with this or go with something else to get a score because you are second at the moment.
Through the legs. He is second on this.
Come on,
I mean, no pressure, but something else.
Oh!
doesn't fall.
A double pump.
Judges, we don't have a problem with that.
Well, I think he got a little bit rattled.
Great first attempt though, give a round of applause. The 360 is not easy to do. Daryl is also from Queensland. Daryl
has
Daryl is also goal. Oh, what have we got? Oh! Some Dr. J stuff.
If you, my goodness.
The Queensland boys are up and about.
Oh my God.
Daryl is up. Is he about?
Oh.
That one was a little bit further out.
I mean, he's trying to get Jordan at the moment. He's like Derek Rose.
He's giving this thing a red hot crack. He's well outside.
Can we stick with these? You've only got one attempt left. Yep.
Come on, right.
Here we go.
He did.
And he jammed it down some poor kid's throat. Oh!
Oh.
He's still got it though! Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for David.
He had it. That is a great. And there's people across the other side. They're standing ovation for that. There's a five.
We've got a six from Andrew again.
That takes him to 11. What will Cal give him?
They give it a six.
He was the only player to make both dunks.
But I think David from WA is our slam dunk champion. Let's give it a
dunk champion. Our dunk contest champion from WA, from the IB team, the IBird, which obviously is about promoting kids and giving kids with an intellectual disability and an opportunity.
Next time we're going to pull coach and runs in conjunction with the other ladies and gentlemen, please also give up to the two boys from Queensland as well.
Dave Wins, the initial dunk contest. Give it up to Dave, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you check out the Basketball Australia Facebook page. Check it out, Basketball Australia. Alternatively, you can check out the pictures or post the pictures of Basketball Australia and use the at symbol at Basketball, AUS, Basketball Australia. Or alternatively, check them out on Twitter, Basketball AUS, and they will tweet you back. Check them out. They do a tremendous job of promoting a great game that gives kids great life lessons. Obviously, as we see, our first initial dunk contest winner, a young guy by the name of David from WA, who obviously has an intellectual disability, which, you know, basketball provides pathways for kids.
Just fantastic.
Every and all
absolutely fantastic.
Got 10 trips.
drives baseline.
This is see Coach Rush over there encouraging, you know, giving them all the medicine they need to keep believing that, you know, this is the strict underdog type situation, you know, and now we're going to try to become the big dog down in Tasmania, and that could be very, very exciting for the state of basketball, who are trying to get a National Basketball League team too. So you can take these kids for a good starters, you know.
Jock Perry with a turnover. I don't know about you, Cal, but as a coach, I hated seeing point guards pass the ball back to the five man in the backcourt. I hated it.
Well, I use them as a safety, but I don't want them to see them going anywhere but back to the point guard when they get a catch as a relief effort, you know?
The pull-up two from
Barker. Down 10. There they go. Oh, that's good on Tasmania. Like I said, they're trying to live and die on the three-point line. You said how many was 22 attempts?
Yeah, they had at the half, they had 23 attempts from the three-point line.
And you got Jock shooting out there now, too. He said, shoot, I got to get a shot some kind of way. Look at that. Another one.
For three. No good. Perry with another rebound. Wilson will slow it up and will look to execute here in the half court. The Vicks trail by 9. Vasiljevic tries to work his way. Manages to get a little bit of space, but Perry will pick up the loose ball that was blocked. They trail by 7 now, 46-53.
He's hot.
Oh. He's feeling it. Jack White.
Gotta stop the ball. You gotta drop it.
And just too strong. Earns himself an offensive rebound. And he is pumped about that. Checking in for the Victorians will be Owies. He converts the and one, and they've shortened the lead to the halftime deficit of 4. It's now 49 to Victoria, 53 to Tasmania. The Vicks seem to have mixed it up a little bit on defense to slow down the Tasmanian team. Going to a 1-2-2 zone. Krebs with no conscience. Tassie exposing the D boards, or the lack thereof, from Victoria. Krebs. Perry will challenge it. Here comes Wilson. Oh! Kyle Clark with a big, big block. But again, it's that guy, Jack White, getting his hands on the offensive glass and being everywhere. As he calls a steal again. That's Vasiljevic. Feeling it.
10-point lead just evaporated.
It did. And Victoria, with their first lead of the game, off a steal from White, he hands it or lays it back to Vasiljevic, and he, with a hand in his face, pulls the trigger and says, come and get it. 54-53, the Vicks are up.
That was a heck of a segment there, you know, to watch Tasmania push it out and drop three straight threes, and then just watch Victoria say, we're not fazed. We'll come back and give you a little bit of our own off hustle, rebounding, and then DJ. Yeah, he's special. He's a pretty special player.
Oh, I mean, for any kid to have 18 points in you know, almost 2 and a bit quarters of basketball is obviously something. But, you know, he's a kid that obviously, you know, as we saw with the FIBA group, you know, the FIBA Oceania tournament where he represented Australia, you know, And he's obviously received a lot of recognition on that next stage, because recently he went to the All-Star game and was part one of two players, along with, I believe, Tom Wilson, to go and play and be recognised at the NBA Without Borders, Basketball Without Borders program, and be part of the All-Star weekend, which is obviously a massive opportunity and shows how talented these athletes really are.
Yeah, I didn't hear about that, but that's good to hear. That's good to know. And, you know, when you got that sort of thing on your resume, then it's all good. Because when you get a chance to put your talent against other top players in the world, your confidence starts to ooze, you know, and therefore you get a chance to feel that, okay, I belong, and then you start working on your game that extra bit just to try to develop it.
Jack White in the right place at the right time. Again, Victoria extending out now to be in a 1-2-2 half-court trap. Just slowed as we see. Oh, he slipped. No, he did not break his ankles. There is a little bit of water on the floor down there, ladies and gentlemen, as White picks up the defensive board again. Foul will be on Jack White. Well, he's getting stats everywhere. He might as well have a foul, I suppose. Krebs wants it. Wilson unable to catch the defensive rebound. It comes back to Tasmania. And the Vicks go to work again in this zone. Forcing the turnover, they're out and running. And they steal it back. Clark looking for the three, it is not on. Clark inside, working against Perry with the reverse layup.
Good move, nice move. He took his time and made sure he cleared himself and got some space between Big Jock and the basket. Oh, he did it again. Got away with it that time, but there's Big Jock.
White almost getting his own rebound. The ball will go back to Tasmania as there's more subs made by Coach Ben Rush. Chilcott and Brown will check in. And it's a one-point ball game, 4 minutes and 3 seconds to go on the third quarter. As Perry will check out, he's been serviceable, obviously, providing a presence around the rim, but they bring it back on McCarthy to even the matchups here, so we'll be interested to see if they stay in this zone. They are in the 1-2-2 half-court trap. Clark.
Aggressive. Oh.
And Wilson has it knocked away by Brown, so they will retain the ball. 13 seconds to go on the shot clock, and Tassie are up by one. Wilson for three. It's like a game of chess. You move, we counter move.
You shoot a three, I'm going to shoot a three. Good move. There we go. Here go the other three. Oh, man's rebound.
McCarthy. Not as big as Perry, but he can get up as Wilson in.
There was no shot. He's giving him two shots. Not a good call. No.
Ben Rush
That's
asking all. The question, and he's received a warning here. Cal seems to agree.
I agree. That was a bad call. He fouled him, and then he went and threw it up. But they're good for doing that this tournament. The and one, the continuation, really, for these young kids is not a good idea, you know.
And Wilson extends it. I mean, previously he hit a three, and that's something that this kid has really added to his game. He's become a knockdown shooter from range. You know, a couple of years ago in 16s and 18s, you know, is this same length, same body build. But, you know, a year or so at the Institute as well as then.
What?
Oh my God.
I
think the referee's got that one wrong.
Well, that's two in a row, and that can kind of break your spirit. You know, when they just blatantly, I mean, he threw the ball, it went off the defensive play, it went in the backcourt.
Tasmania need to relax here, and obviously I've read the scouting report because they ran that play early in the week.
Ah.
McCarthy picking up the loose pass. White getting deep in the paint, finds Vasiljevic. He can't connect on the floater.
He was too close.
He's too close. Do you hear that, DJ? You were too close, mate. You got to step outside a little bit. As we see Krebs again.
This is a great exhibition for this under 20 top talent in the Australia game. You know, these young kids are playing their hearts out. They're hitting shots. They're making plays, and they're pushing each other.
Tanner Krebs has gone 3 from 12 from the three-point line and only shot 2 shots inside the three-point line. Now, I'm sorry, most people will look at that stats at home and go, well, he's not having a good shooting day, but the scary thing is that he will get hot at the drop of a hat, and it could be over. Always keeping the dribble alive, as the man sitting beside me used to do quite well.
That's it. No, don't hesitate. Don't think about it. Make him guard you.
Clark. White again with another rebound.
How many has he?
He takes his tally.
10 at least.
He's close. He's on 7 at the moment. He's got 13 points to go with that. 2 assists, a turnover, a steal, a block, and 1 foul. Clark. McCarthy trying to go to work inside against Krebs.
Mm.
With the hook, doesn't get it. Always on the long offensive rebound, has a look. Wilson gets it, and they'll pull it out and run something. Vasiljevic loses it. Step back. Too long, and that's a rarity. A Victorian shot clock violation. That very rarely happens.
Mm. Yeah, because they got enough shooters to hit the construction, I can tell you. But to get the shot up and not get a chance to get that offensive board, particularly with the shot clock going down, is a credit to Tasmania's defense.
As we see the Tassie boys beat the 1-2-2 half-court trap, but can't convert inside. They're continuing to go inside and try and find penetration because there's big holes there to be found.
This is a big stop right here. I'll foul him right there. I would have fouled him first. Now, you got plenty of time. Plenty of time.
Krebs with no conscience.
Oh.
Is short. And at the end of the third quarter, Victoria have regained the lead. It's a 5-point swing in all that action. A 1-point ball game.
1-point ball game. Well, we haven't seen that. Oh, I didn't expect that. But Victoria have a little bit of a bigger lead by now, but just goes to show Tasmania is right in there. The talent is not far apart, so comes down to who's going to hit shots in this fourth quarter, or whether Jock appearance in the paint at 6'11" starts to have a real effect on the game, you know, because he's going to he's going to be there when Tasman might be a little tired, and he can pick up those loose balls, those loose rebounds around the hoop and put them back in.
Absolutely. As we look at the stats now, ladies and gentlemen, leading all scorers, it's a shootout of the Center of Excellent kids, where we see Kyle Clark from Tasmania with 18 points. And we also see Dejan DJ, or Wet Vasiljevic, with 18 points. For the Vics, we've got Jack White with 13 points. He's on fire and at the moment set to have a double-double with 8 boards. Jock Perry, the man you're talking about, at 6'11", 12 points, 6 rebounds. As well as then Tom Wilson with 12 points. For the Tassie boys, it's Ben Barker with 17. He's also gone and got 4 rebounds and 3 steals, surprisingly. And he's been aptly helped by Chilcott with 13, 6 rebounds to go with his 13. And then Tanner Krebs, the captain and the man to watch in this fourth quarter, 4 of 14 from the three-point line, only at 29%, but he's got 14 points.
Well, you know, the shooting percentage is not there with him, but I don't think he's going to go shy. And, you know, like you said, if he can get hot as drop a hat, he can swing that game in Tasmania's favor pretty quick. So it's on. Good game.
For all you watching at home, probably the one distinguishing stat at the moment is that Victoria have 8 more rebounds than Tasmania. That is really the only difference across the floor is the rebounds. And the assists to Tasmania, obviously, they rely on a style of penetrate, kick, and find the open shooter. So naturally, they have more assists. But 1 point and 9 minutes separate the Australian Junior Championships.
Yep, there's not much in it. Here you go.
He got it off, and Brown.
I like him. He's a hustler.
I mean, how tall do you think that kid is, Cal?
About 6'2".
About 6'2", and playing at what, 6'10"? As we see.
Big shot.
Always. With a big bucket three to regain the lead.
Here comes a DJ special. Bring up a pick. Here you go.
Krebs finds Brown. A wide open Barker. No good.
Oh.
McCarthy picks it up. And the Vics look to run. Wilson driving baseline. Thought he got hit.
Oh.
Stays with the play. And McCarthy again.
There's the rebound. There's the fatigue factor showing.
Oh, he's going to work. Finds Dejan. I think you're right, Cal. I think he's a little too close.
Nah, yeah, you got to step out a little bit.
Krebs working the on ball again.
Oh, my
Gets
God.
Into the paint.
Nice move.
Too easy.
Bad luck. He handles the ball really nicely. Kicked it.
Kick ball.
He kicked it.
As we see Kyle Clark checking back in. Whilst we see Finno sit down. Brown will check it out. And you will check in.
Uh-oh. There you go. Here to stop the fast break.
Jack White using all of his experience there to go and get a foul and pretty much stop a fast break layup, which is a big momentum swing in this kind of close game.
Well, that would have tied it up, so he still got the lead and make them earn it.
We see White check out and Akintola check back in.
Oh,
Krebs. Finding Clark. Clark to Chilcott.
He's tough. He's really tough. If you've seen him on the streets, he wouldn't look like a player. but he's lefty. I love lefties.
And he can shoot.
He's a marksman.
And he can shoot the ball. Vasiljevic going to work.
Okay, here we go.
Wants to go to work on Clark. Oh, with a crossover. Akitola can't get the O-board.
Oh, got it back. Oh, this is scrappy. There you go.
Oh, he's
this is scrappy.
Off
oh.
the back of the rim. Vasiljevic wants it against his teammate at the center of excellence. Switches onto Yule, switches onto him.
Big shot. No.
Violation. Smith will check in for Owies, who will have a seat. 66 to the Victorians, 67 to Tasmania. 6 minutes to go. Clark to Yule.
Whoa. Lucky there.
Chilcott the rebound.
Fair
kick
give
out.
It to me
extra
now,
pass.
Baby.
There he is. Tanner Krebs.
Okay, he's on. Final six.
I think maybe you or CJ have been teaching him because he's shooting with flat out no conscience right now. McCarthy works inside. Krebs again. Stop it! Stop it! Somebody has got to get a hand to that.
He's shooting like Jerry. He's shooting like Jerry West and Steph Curry, all in the one. They gotta come back with a Tom.
Akintola with a rebound. They needed that. But I think the Tasmanians have a saying, three is better than two.
Oh.
Clark!
Oh!
With the exclamation mark! Perry is about to check back in.
There you go, that's
Smith
a big shot.
Needs that to go. Rebound Ewell.
Wow.
75 to the Tassie boys, 70 to the Victorians. Krebs wants it. On McCarthy, draws the contact, and he will shoot two easy ones.
I think you called it, John. You said, you know, he can get hot at the drop of a hat.
He's just gone two in a row and gone 6 of 16. He's only shot three shots inside the three-point line, and he's got 20 points. Four rebounds, two assists, one turnover, one steal. The kid can flat out ball.
Yeah, he's kind of special, definitely. He's special. He's going places. Coming from Tasmania, that's nice. And they're well coached. They really are. You know, you don't see that sort of confidence in young men to be able to sort of take over a game. You know, with the blessings of your coach and your teammates, you know, they coming back to you. And I suppose they also give him the responsibility to make his teammates better. So he's not afraid to kick it right back to them when they open, you know.
And I think the difference, Cal, you're right. I think the difference is that many people coming into this tournament would have predicted that Kyle Clark and Tanner Krebs would have been the standouts, and they have been. But the impressive part is that Chilcott, Barker, Brown, Ewell, they're all stepping up around them, and they're doing the dirty work, and they're growing with the group.
With the group. A pretty special group, I would say. NBL, just put the under 20 team in the National Basketball League. Get two big imports, and you're good to go.
You heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen. Tasmania's NBL bid needs to sign this team and get a couple of imports.
That's it.
Now, will you be coaching?
No, no, no. That's Mr. Rush's job right there. You know, matter of fact, if I had the opportunity, I'll hire him as a coach if I had a team.
We see Perry try to force the ball on the reversal, and it is deflected out of bounds. 12 seconds left on the shot clock. Victoria ball from the baseline. They trail by 7 on the back of some hot three-point shooting from Tanner Krebs.
They're switching everything, too. I like that.
Wilson. With the answer.
Yeah. He's definitely stepped up his game, too. Now they got to get stops. Here he comes. He's got the defensive stop on him now. He's done got personal. Oh, first one he missed. Oh!
Tazzy with the offensive rebound. Brown at it again underneath Perry. Managed to force the tip out. It looked from here like there was a little bit of contact. The referees didn't.
A little bit. I think they let him off. They gave Victoria a break on that one. And he hurt his ankle or knee or something. He's a little bit gimpy. But looked like he's a warrior.
Victoria going into a shuffle set. Finding the hot hand in Wilson. He can't get it to go. Tasmania will slow it down and look to execute. 3 minutes 10 to go. They lead by 4. Uh-oh.
Nope.
Rebound Clark.
Good job.
Clark finding that man Brown. Jack White pins it. Clark at it again. Jack White telling him to get it out. Foul on Brown with a smart play. Victoria out and running. It was going to be, someone was about to end up on a poster. Jack White with potentially a game-changing 2 blocks.
Well, it's a momentum swinger. If they score on this one, you look definitely at that particular play and say, yep, that was that determination, dedication, and desire to make sure they didn't have that easy bucket to make a difference. Now he's trying to get in the paint. And
Jack White. Jack Flight White. He's a very unassuming looking kid. Very quiet kid, very well spoken. Extremely respectful. Goes about his business in a deceiving way because he doesn't look for a lot of attention, but he can play. As we see Clark drawing a foul, he will shoot 2 shots.
Okay.
Just a quick shout out to all our volunteers. Dandenong Stadium has put on a great week of basketball, have they not? I mean, a facility like this is one of the biggest in the world. And
how many courts there? 16 or something?
Too many. Too many. I need a tour guide to get around here, Cal. But the staff here, the management team, obviously led by the CEO, Dave Graham, aptly helped by Renee Narsis from Basketball Australia, Jardine Ormsey, under the leadership of Graham Allen, who used to be the CEO here. You know, they've put together great championships. Thank you to the volunteers, the staff, the referees, the coaches, the parents, the friends, the family for coming out. As we see, Tasmania leading 77-75. Clark makes it a 3-point ball game.
Okay. Now it comes down to the D. Here's one stop.
Veseljevic.
Oh,
doesn't get
his
own
rebound. And, oh. Okay. The big play here. Oh.
Perry.
Yeah, John's talking smack to him, you know?
God, I wish we had these kids mic'd up because it would be...
Now Jock is ready to go to work on. Okay, big possession here. Major possession right here.
1 minute 42. It's 3-1 foul count. Tassie up by three. It's got to go to Krebs.
Yep.
Six.
Okay.
Five, four, three. Clark with a one-legged.
Oh!
Did he just Dirk Nowitzki him?
Got to get a timeout, coach. Oh, yeah.
I haven't seen that move by an Australian, but there's a big German who loves that move. A one-foot
Nowitzki
fadeaway step back. The great Dirk Nowitzki. Wow. 1 minute 18. Now, if you're Trevor Lee and you're the Victorian coach on your home court as the defending undefeated champions, what are you saying to your players right now, Cal?
I'm just here because I don't want to get fired. So we got to pull out one right here. And I'll be working. I'll be trying to get something inside. You don't have to go for a three. You know, it's more focused on the defensive end of the court. We got to work to get to the basket and see if we can put them under pressure. Because Tasmania's only got one foul for the whole quarter. So that shit tells me that they're not in attack. I'm trying to get close to the basket and post up. You know, Jock is now outside the keyway, so he's not really a factor. I'll probably try to get him something right at the front of the rim. But Tasmania's got their backup now.
They really have. And the surprising thing is, there seems to be sections of the crowd that are rallying behind Tasmania on Victoria's home floor.
Well, you know, Victoria's so dominant in every phase of the game, in every division. So everyone likes the underdog, you know. And now you're going to see whether or not they can get it. So, yep, this is an opportunity for them right here. One stop.
Vasiljevic wants it.
Okay, they're using up some clock. One stop. It's on Tom Wilson. Here you go, to the hole. Yep. Big shot. Three.
Smith.
Nope. Oh!
Off the backboard. The bank is open.
Did he call it?
I don't think he did.
Now they got to get a stop. Okay, here he comes.
Krebs being tightly guarded by Smith. Chilcott, baseline. Steps out of bounds. White with a big defensive play. The kid has been everywhere. He does the dirty work. And whenever something has gone right for Victoria, he's close by.
Well, I can tell you this. Tasmania get the last shot, which is big. They got a score. Well, I would have had a 2-for-1. Because right now, there he is. There he is.
Smith.
Whoa.
Finding Perry. Tied ball game with 27.6 seconds left. It is all tied up. That's a lot of basketball to be played. And surprisingly, they went to Smith and found a wide open Perry for a layup. I thought he was going to throw that thing down and put some poor kid from Tassie on a post.
He definitely did a slow motion two-step down there on the baseline. I didn't know whether the referee wanted to call that a travel. At that point, again, he would have got walked out of this gym quite nicely. So now you come down to one stop for the Vicks. That was Tassie. You don't really want to go overtime with him. But at the same time, you can win this in regulation. But I like to do it from the offense rather than the defense.
27.6 seconds left on the game clock. Tassie will have a full 24 seconds. Advance the ball. It's 80 points to all. This is for a national championship. Tassie, I don't think, have ever beaten Victoria on their home court. in a grand final. This is the group to do it. And the interesting thing is they've had the lead.
Yeah. Yeah, that 5-point turnaround, that bank off the glass, I will ask my man, did you call that?
I believe Jack Smith has gone and got a bank loan yesterday. The ball has got to go to Krebs.
They're going for one shot.
Veseljevic guarding the ball. They're trying to get Krebs open. Blocked by Perry. 9 seconds left. 11.6 on the shot on the game clock. There will be another timeout for Tasmania. The ball will be passing from the baseline. Now, if as a coach, there's ever a time to go to that black book and come up with the greatest play of your life, is this not what you dream about?
I would say, you know what? It's the old Michael Jordan story from Phil Jackson. Give the ball to Mr. Krebs and get the hell out of his way.
I like it. You heard it here first, folks. Check out Tanner Krebs. He is the one that Carl, the Black Pearl, thinks the ball's going to go into. And you know what? You're probably right.
Just give it, yep.
There's still enough time, though, for Victoria. 2.6 seconds. There's still enough time with a timeout to advance the ball.
True. I'm sure everyone's pretty tired after a long week, but you still wouldn't mind seeing overtime.
I think every fan here and everyone watching at home loves a close game. But if we can get to overtime, then it's even better. Krebs is open.
What I say? Here you go.
Krebs with the ball.
Here you go. Get out of his way.
Smith guarding him.
Get out of his way. Oh!
He finds Brown. Brown at the three.
Oh!
Overtime. We are headed. Hang on a second. I don't think that was the play they drew up.
No.
The ball was forced from Krebs' hands. They helped on him, and Brown ended up with it and had to throw it up. Fortunately for Tasmania, they got a hand on it and it stayed in play. And we're headed to overtime. For those of you playing at home, the foul count will stay. We will play another 5 minutes of basketball to decide the 2015 Australian Junior Championship Men's Under 20 winner. It's 80 all. Five minutes.
That's a big time game for a grand final, and I think everybody is so deserving of it after a long week, you know. And you think that Victoria would have been down five with less than a couple minutes to go. It was over and out. But just goes to show the Victorians never say die. They always believe. And I'm still thinking about that kiss off the glass. You probably say, yeah, I knew it was going in as soon as it left my hands. Reminds me of CJ when he made his first basket in NBL on the buzzer, 1994. I'm living in Hobart. All we had was the ABC, so I didn't get a chance to see it until I saw the video. But he's coming across the half court. And they tell him, shoot it, shoot it. He's let it fly. And it's kissed off the glass. So I've gone to him and said, how'd you go today? He said, oh, it was all right. It was good. Yeah, we had a win. I said, really? I said, how'd you go? He said, oh, it was okay. I said, someone told me you made a nice shot. He said, oh, yeah, I made it off the backboard half court. As soon as it left my hands, I knew it was going in. I said, your grandmother put that one in, my friend.
You heard it here first, folks. One of the greatest players to represent Australia and to play in the NBL, who played at this very tournament, has obviously done similar sort of things.
Yeah, the WA team was well represented as under 20. They were pretty good.
Right. Wow. Jack White is a flat-out beast.
Yeah, he's MVP right now. If they win it.
Clark. They're trying to find Krebs. White okay, on Krebs. The best two players in the country right at this moment.
Oh! Oh! It's nasty. Okay, Krebs. What? You and Jack. Okay, you and Jack White. Let's do it. Let's do this.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Veseljevic going
there
to work.
Going.
Sees the helpline. Pulls up and floats in. He doesn't want to miss out on the action.
That's why he said, well, you know what? I missed the last few close ones. This is going down. I put the soft touch on him. Yeah.
Krebs to Clark.
And a foul.
And one! Kyle Clark on Wilson.
And switch it to the left. These boys are balling.
I don't want to go home.
Well, you could be in for a double overtime.
There was a couple of those this week. So
there was, the girls had one, yeah. And it was all Tasmania, too.
Clark, short. Wilson, the rebound.
Oh,
loose ball.
Oh, White. Jack White, though.
Gets his hands on it. They pull it out, and they're going to execute. Veseljevic on Clark. Splits the D. Floater.
Oh.
He is feeling it right now. He is feeling it.
He's tough. He's tough. Jack's trying to get a foul, because they're dogging him now. Here you go.
Krebs with a hand in his face.
Oh!
Wow!
Oh. They're balling. They're straight up balling.
86 to 88. The Tassie boys are up by two. We are trading buckets here at Dandenong Stadium.
Tom Wilson.
Wilson. They will call the continuation, and I know this is something you said earlier, Cal. There has been the continuation question. Is it? Isn't it? You know, obviously these kids watch a lot of NBA, NBL, WNBL. You know, that is an elite level, but they're getting those traits from that level.
And that's good. I mean, if they're going to get a chance to go to America and they, you know, they're sampling and watching the game and picking up those little pointers, don't ever stop the play, continue through. It's something that's going to hold them in good stead down the road.
As we see Tom Wilson take the game 89-88. The Vicks are up for the first time in quarter time. Overtime. The first time in overtime. Krebs again.
Oh!
I told you. I told you.
Oh!
I told you.
He's a bad boy.
He's a bad boy.
Y'all gotta call him a boy because he's still a kid.
He's still a kid.
Here comes another dunk.
White.
He's tossing him in there. Ooh! Oh!
Can't get it. He's on his own rebound.
Child. He's a man child.
91 all. White sticking with the play like a dog with a bone was not going to give up on that one. 91 all. White has a double-double and he is in beast mode. I think he stole Marshawn Lynch's hashtag and he's going beast mode right now.
He is.
Oh. Can't get the roll, though. We're all tied up.
Okay, all tied up again.
Krebs is 9 of 19 and has 31.
Mm-hmm.
Veseljevic DJ on Krebs. He finds the open man.
There you go.
Oh. They chase it. Veseljevic knocks it loose to Wilson.
There he is. There he is.
White doesn't want it. Smith. Hard at the rim. Will get two. One minute and 9 seconds left in the overtime. Four fouls each. It's 91 all. Yeah, a kid who helped him get here, surprisingly, Smith, banked a three to level it all up earlier in regulation, is now at the foul line to put the Victorians up two.
He's a good player, too. I like him. He's a bit of an athlete. He's got that that toughness about him. And also, he's offensively, I think he's more than adequate. You know, watching the way he hounds the ball and pulls up, lovely jumper. And he obviously responds under pressure. So these are big free throws.
Very cool, calm, and collected at this point of the game, obviously. As we hear the Victorian crowd start to get into this thing and start to rally the troops.
Okay, DJ's got, DJ said, okay.
Two of the best players in the country are about to go at it. Wilson.
Okay, here you go.
Smith on Krebs. Brown with the ball. Perry on Brown. The kick out. Oh.
Oh.
Little no
nope
look.
Short.
Oh. Brown. They forgot to guard him.
All right, another stop. You say you want to be here all night?
We might not go home.
There's going to be another one. Here you go. This is it.
The on ball.
10 seconds. On ball. Switching them. Uh-oh. We're switching. Tom going to the hoop. And, oh.
Can't get the roll.
Okay. One shot. Going for the win.
He wants it.
Going for the win.
The crowd is getting up in the air. They are starting to rise. Wilson on Krebs. He goes to work. He wants it. Oh! We are going to a second overtime.
It went in?
It nearly went in. It was well after the buzzer, but he put it off the back of the iron. Ladies and gentlemen.
Only disappointment, he should have went to the bucket. You got four fouls up there. You got to try to draw one. What a great game.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have just tuned in, we have just watched 45 minutes of the best basketball seen at under-20s nationals, probably in as long as I've been alive, Cal, and that's 28 years.
Well, I don't know about any double overtime games when you get to this level, and particularly that Tasmania has been involved with, but over this weekend, their girls went double overtime, the men now double overtime. It just goes to show that there's some real talent on display here, and it's good to see.
Leading all scorers, and we said it. I'm gonna say Tanner Krebs, I told you so, has 31 and has gone 9 of 20 from the 3-point line. 9 of 20. He's shot 45%. He's aptly helped by Kyle Clark with 25. Barker's chipped in with 17, which has been surprising. Chilcott, 16. Brown, who's made two shots, has made two massive shots, one in overtime to tie it all up at four.
They're all playing. They're all supporting each other. And when you look at it, the balance amongst the starting five is right on the money. And Victoria has pretty much got the same. You know, with DJ sort of, and Jack White.
I mean, and speaking of those two, Cal, as you said, DJ's got 22. He's shooting the ball 4 of 7 beyond the arc. Jack White has been hashtag beast mode, Marshawn Lynch. I think he'll be happy with that nickname. 19 points, 12 rebounds. Three blocks. Tom Wilson.
Three dunks too.
18 points from Tom Wilson. He's got 8 boards and 4 assists. As we enter the second overtime, 93 apiece. Tasmania start with the ball. Can't get the roll. And that was Chilcott. Veseljevic.
Wow. What a sweet shot.
It's a quick release too.
He's face guarding Jack White. Yeah.
He's into Krebs. The Victorians lead 96-93. Veseljevic just hit a massive three to take his tally to 5 of 8 and 25 points for the game. Clark inside, easy two.
He's a tough boy. Yeah, he's a tough boy.
Very composed for a guy of his size. Doesn't panic under pressure.
No.
Perry inside. He'd been quiet. They had to go to 6'11" of him sometime.
Nice pass by Tom Wilson.
For those of you watching at home, it is not your TV screens, it's not your live stream, it's not your internet feed. We are experiencing a big storm that had been building all week. And it's just caused a few of the lights here to flicker. So we're just going to have a short break of play until these lights come back on or until the players' eyes adjust. We're just going to have a few technical changes. The score is 98 Victoria, 95 Tasmania, 4 fouls apiece.
I'm a little bit upset though.
There is a massive score. We're just going to give you some updates, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. We've got one of the biggest names in basketball today. Big Joe Terzakian, the man of many talents, obviously taking care of the Bullets and the Blazers for many years, here with the Queensland Under 20 women, done a tremendous job watching his boy, Joey Wright, who I believe is on his 350th game in the NBL, which is amazing for a man of his talents because he's a very talented coach. Score update as we see it right now. New Zealand are 41, Adelaide are 34, and it's 4 minutes to go in the second quarter. So I do apologize for anyone waiting for a replay or anything like that, but New Zealand are winning 41-34, 4 minutes to go on the second, the NBL. Just a reminder, ladies and gentlemen, I've got the great man, Hall of Fame legend, the Black Pearl, Cal Bruton, who's been with us this week, coaching the under-20 ACT boys, giving back to the game. We're on a short break because of a storm we're experiencing here at Dandenong Stadium. The score is 98-95 to the Victorians. We are in double overtime. 98-95, 3 minutes 29 to play. Cal, it's great to have you here. Obviously, the week has been tremendous. We watched you with the dunk contest before, which I believe we're going to get some footage of later. All the fans can check it out on the Basketball Australia Facebook page, Twitter and Instagram. Make sure you check them out, Basketball Australia on Facebook. Use the hashtag AJC. That stands for Australian Junior Championships. The dunk contest was won by a man from WA. Who dunked in socks, who, believe it or not, is here with the Ivor Birch Championship.
That's right. That was kind of special. And as I said, I was just hopeful that he wouldn't have to cash in on the Dandenong insurance policy because he was determined. I said to him, where's your shoes? he had him tucked in the doorway just in case he can pick up this trophy and keep walking.
Well, so, he definitely did that, because for those of you who don't know, the Ivan Birch Championships partner with the Australian Under-20s, and Cal and I have been fortunate enough to come here this week and watch these great talented athletes in that championship compete. And they're amazing players to watch, aren't they? They have a true desire and love for the game.
They do. They do. And they play with an intensity that's probably second to none either when you think about it. They're not just jogging up and down the floor. They're trying to fast break on every opportunity. And it's only when they run out of puff do they decide to execute in the half court, because other than that, it's flat chat up and down. And if you blink, you might miss something the way they're running up and down the floor. So I was quite taken. I sat and watched a couple of those games. And as you said, they played with a great spirit. And they enjoy each other after the game, win, lose, or draw. They're happy as just to be participating in the comp. And to me, that's what it's really all about. You know, when you get those young people wanting to showcase their abilities in a forum like this. So I think the best is yet to come for all these sort of tournaments like that.
Absolutely, Cal, as you said, you know, this great sport has given you many wonderful years, and you continue to give back, which is a pleasure to see. But anyone looking to get into the game at a primary school level, Basketball Australia has relaunched their new primary school age program. It's pretty much for about three, four, five-year-olds to 11-year-olds, primarily aimed at primary school kids. Across the country, Patty Mills with the San Antonio Spurs, one of ACT Basketball's great products, obviously Indigenous player, and played with the Spurs and won a championship. And Lauren Jackson, again, a kid out of Albury, ambassadors for the program. Make sure you check it out. If you want to get your kids involved, aussiehoops.com.au. They have their own Facebook page. There's centres all around the country ready to play. We rejoin action, 3 minutes 27 to go in double overtime of the Under 20 Australian Men's Junior Championship Final.
Nice, tough drive. You know, you look at it, he just went to the hole and would not be denied that basket. I think they got a slight advantage with the Tasman. They ended the course a little bit brighter than the Vicks.
Jack White! Beast mode! Four dunks. And I think just as many blocks. It is 100 Victoria to 97 Tasmania. For those of you watching at home, yes, the lights, some of which have gone out because we are experiencing a massive storm here, so that's why we had a break. DJ Veseljevic can't get it. Jock Perry can't put it back in.
Ooh, that would have been crucial. They got out to a 5-point lead. Close.
Get to the rim with ease. It's a one-point ball game.
Yeah, what a pressure in that D.
100-99, 1 minute 49 to play in double overtime. Victoria taking on Tasmania in the Under-20 Australian Junior Championship Final. Tom Wilson.
Big shot. Big shot. Oh.
Stepped out of court. Barker lost his footing and stepped out of court. The Victorians have the largest lead of double overtime with 4 points off the back of a massive Jack White beast mode dunk. And Tom Wilson dagger three.
Yep, that's the way I'll sum that up too, just like that. Now he's going again, Tom Wilson.
He wants it. He hangs, he holds, he fires, and gets his own rebound. Perry.
Oh. Referee's letting him play, which is good. He's going by him. And, oh, no.
just like that, it's a two-point ball game. So the crowd is going a little bit nuts here because the score had gone on the wrong side. It's a two-point ball game, 101-101. 103-101, I apologize.
You said you didn't want to go home? One stop by Tasmania, you won't be going home.
Joe Perry manages to keep it alive, regain the ball, and bank it in.
With the left hand.
He's been big literally and figuratively.
At the end of the game, he's still going to be 6'10".
If you just joined us, ladies and gentlemen, it is the Australian Under-20 Men's Junior Championship. We are in double overtime. I'm joined by the great man, the Black Pearl, Hall of Fame legend, Cal Bruton, who's been coaching the ACT Under-20 Men this week. Done a tremendous job bringing this group of boys together. Shout out to those boys who are obviously here in the stadium and their girls who have done a tremendous job. Some of the best talent in the country here. 105, 101. We've got how many? We have 2,700 viewers streaming this live. I can't imagine how many are going to go back later and watch this at home, Cal, but obviously it's a pleasure to be working next to you, having looked up to you my entire life.
Thank you, Joey.
What do you think?
I just think it's a great game. I wouldn't see why you wouldn't tune into it, you know? If you went in and just saw the quality of the basketball that these young men are putting on, you can't help but stay tuned in, you know? And there's no commercials, so you just locked into the seat. I just think these kids are doing themselves a great service in the way they've just put on this display today. Uh-oh, big shot. Off the board.
The window is open. It is a one-point ball game.
So 6 seconds, eh?
There's about a five to six second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Victoria lead 105 to 104 as the clock winds down.
Okay.
Seven on the shot clock.
Switching it.
Wilson.
Oh!
Uh-oh.
Oh!
Uh-oh.
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 Oh! This is it.
This
uh-oh.
Is
there
it.
You go. There you go. Triple overtime. What a great
it
game.
It is a standing ovation, a showcase of basketball. Victoria, stay alive.